Stolas relay station to the receiving network, over.
Roger.
Yes, we're performing a systems check. Transmission sequence 2.37. The test date is October 30th, 2022. The time is 2351 UTC. Our current utilization is coming in at 39%, transmitting at 3100 kbps. Current utilization is stable. Atmospheric temperature is negative 98 Celsius with a range of 351 million kilometers. It's a road trip flight time of 3.7 light years. The azimuth is registering at 156 degrees, wind speeds at 7 kilometers per hour. All systems are nominal and ready for transmission. Transmission. Ladies and gentlemen, as we prepare for signal transmission, please make sure your seats are positioned comfortably, your tray tables are in their full upright position, and your listening devices are secure. Our live transmission of global ambient music will begin shortly. Thank you for choosing the Stolas Relay Station, and enjoy your trip. welcome friends and travelers to the Stolas Relay Station, broadcasting original ambient and atmospheric signals to the furthest reaches of our solar system. If your current conditions permit it, close your eyes, lean back, and enjoy these original ambient sounds. Tonight, we celebrate Halloween and the final episode of the Relay Station on Twitch. We present to you a story woven throughout the ambient music collection from the Relay Station, The Rise of the Insect Lord. Strap in and make yourself comfortable. Join us for the next few hours on the Stolas Relay Station.
There were the sounds of horns in the air, a drone of carapace and clanging swords as eclectic Chu, king of the insect world, led his armies out of the capital city. With their heads held high, the soldiers marched in strict unison, proud to serve their king, their country. King Ikthechu's son ran up alongside the caravan, shouting for the attention of his father. With a smile of satisfaction and purpose, he leaned down from his ride toward his son, saying,
"Chitu, one day, you too will lead our people into peace and prosperity. One day, you will rule in my stead."
The young prince, she too, couldn't sleep a wink that night, daydreaming about the day that he would become king, ruminating over the finer details of the pageantry, the great spectacle in his honor, and hearing his name echoing throughout the city streets. The would-be boy king was swept up and consumed by his naive ambitions, with visions of great feasts, songs being sung in his name, and the pomp and circumstance of the crowning ceremony. The scouts return from the battle to give report, entering the throne room with a look of unfathomable fatigue.
The conflict was brutal, Queen Mum, and the outcome severe despite barely claiming victory over our sworn enemy. So many lives lost, so much blood spilt.
Turning towards the Queen, the scout hesitated.
Queen Mum, the King has fallen.
From behind the curtains came a shriek of horror at the discovery of his father's death on the battlefield. The would-be boy king, Chitu. Would-be king.
Thank you.
News of the king's death spread quickly, and with it a splintering within the city walls. There were rumors, whispers, and grumblings in the streets, as zealots began gathering in shadows, plotting in darkness. Propaganda and misinformation started appearing throughout the city, contending the boy king's legitimacy, citing a long list of wild accusations. Though far from the truth, the rumblings grew, and sympathy for the zealot cause lit up like leaves in the last day of autumn. A fire was brewing, a threat within. It was a moment of vulnerability for the kingdom, stunned over the death of their king. Without hesitation, the zealot struck a severe blow to the city's stability. Under the cover of night, religious zealots snuck into the palace, murdering the entire royal family, save for one. In an act of desperation, the vice chancellor withdrew Chitu from the palace and brought the boy king into hiding in the catacombs, deep beneath the city. With barely time to grieve, the boy king shuddered and stammered for the words.
What do I do?
With a severe tone in his voice, the vice chancellor said,
"Run, boy, run. Leave at once. The uprising is no place for a boy king."
Thank you.
In a last-ditch effort to prevent a takeover of the city, palace guards loyal to the king vowed to protect and preserve the High King's honor to their very death. Leaderless, kingless, the guards stood their ground outside the palace walls when they heard the sound. The sound of distant horns and pulsing drums. A battle cry from their sworn enemy. It wouldn't be long before the city was besieged.
Thank you.
cowering in the shadows of the Hall of Kings, a catacomb for royalty. The boy king sat with the weight of the world upon his shoulders, recounting the faces of his family, the sounds of their voices, the vivid warmth of their memories. He cried under his breath.
How am I supposed to be the king? I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do.
The would-be boy king cried in the solitude that surrounded him, like a jury ready to declare their verdict, challenging a king's calling.
Thank you.
His eyes were heavy with grief, barely able to stay awake, burdened by the loss of his family in such short order, and with no proper resolution. No funeral, no procession through the streets, no reverent ceremony in the Hall of Kings, laying them to rest with their forebears. As if in a dream, a voice resonated among the tombs.
Boy King, waste not away in the memories of the dead. You cower here in the shadows, while your city burns with betrayal and warmongering. The virtue your father once upheld, deteriorates now with every malcontent whisper that is uttered. Stand now, boy. Feel the blood of kings surging through you. Feel the strength of those who have gone before you. And now stand at your side. Earn your place, boy, in the Hall of Kings.
Thank you.
reborn with a renewed sense of purpose and confidence boiling up within him. The boy king rose from the long oil-lit shadows of the catacombs. With a manner of great stealth, Chitu made his way up toward the city's great watchtower, a defensive beacon for the city, and a symbol of hope, unity, and strength. Summoning the courage of his father, he blew the battle horn of Kyrgodin. Its deep, resonant, brassy sound filled every corner of the city, reverberating off the walls and into every house, every stable, every inn. The call was clear and the message resonated with the people. For the summoner of the throne calls out to you.
Come to our aid. Stand with us, together, as one people.
Thank you.
The resonating battle horn of Kirgoden awoke something within Chitu. A stirring in his blood, an intangible confidence, and a resolve that strangely resembled his father's countenance. Standing before the palace guards with a fire in his eyes and deep-seated hunger for justice within him, the boy king called out,
"You were all once loyal to my father. You defended the throne, our kingdom, our home. Fulfill your oaths, your sworn duty, and ride with me to protect our land."
Thank you.
Support the Stolas Relay Station to reach our benchmarks and maintain continuity. Visit stolas.com/support for more information on how you can show your love for the music created here. Beginning November 6th, the Relay Station will be moving to stolas.com, where you can tune in to original ambient and atmospheric music. You can also listen live or catch previous broadcasts at youtube.com/stolas, as well as on the Mixlr app at stolas.mixlr.com. You can also hear music from the Relay Station album series on streaming music platforms worldwide. The live improv.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Every 4 computers now have primary control of critical vehicle function.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we prepare for signal transmission, please make sure your seats are positioned comfortably. Online transmission of global ambient music will begin. Thank you for choosing the Stolas Relay Station, and enjoy your trip.